Most people don't know, but their gardens contain all sorts of different contaminants in them, especially when we're in urban centers. There's a lot of different stuff that comes from old buildings, from old industrial sites. That can result in things like heavy metals in your soils, like arsenic and lead. I'm Dr. Melanie Malone from University of Washington, Bothell. I study soil science, and I also look at social structures, environmental justice, and how power structures shape garden spaces. Hey, Andrew. Today, we were out at Renewed Church Garden. It was an educational experience for folks that use the garden and showing them how we sample. So it should be full like that. Did everybody kind of see that?
Yeah.
Every year I look at arsenic and lead. I also look at motor oil and diesel, and I look for an herbicide called glyphosate. Some things like Roundup and Crossbow.
And then
explaining to people when I come out, if you eat this much, you know, plants, and sometimes even if you accidentally eat this much of soil, you're gonna get that into your system. They're not good for you.
All that good stuff that we just recorded on our jars.
What kind of contaminants do you all hear about in the Superfund site? So far in this study, I've gone all over Seattle metropolitan area, and unfortunately, the contamination levels reflect a lot of our systemic inequities. So my highest sites are the gardens that are down at the Lower Duwamish Superfund site.
We need a couple people to sample.
It'd be really interesting to find out when you're in the mud, what are you taking home with you? What are you being exposed to?
Get a little bit from all around the earth.
This summer, I'm actually training up quite a few different people to actually sample their own soils. People are super into it and the science of it, and they want to know about if their soils are good for growing things in, if their kids are safe. And so in that way, I really love this project. Like, just the fact that they're really into it and then can have their own insight into what's in their soils and what's in their plants and how to do it accurately is really, you know, profound, I think, in a lot of ways.